Hi there, it's Misha. Today I am at the library, which is the Seattle Public Library downtown. Right now I'm at the highest level. Hopefully that doesn't give you vertigo. And I'm planning on doing some exploring here. And looking at some books. And just generally hanging out. I'm at the highest level of the library. And directly below me, sort of unremarkable from this angle, is the book spiral. I don't know how to film it without dropping my phone, but you walk around and around, and there's a slate ramp that takes you down the spiral through all of the rows of books. So that's where we're headed first, and we can check out what's over there. We are at the top of the spiral, and I don't quite understand the categorization system in this library. I don't think it's the Dewey Decimal System, but these are reference books, I suppose. Maybe that means that they're books that you can't check out, because otherwise they look pretty normal. Dictionaries. Who did what? Oh, that's so. It's just so. I mean, that's everything you ever need to know about the entire world. Another international who's who of 1939. Lists of people. So biographies, I guess, are at the very top. And then we get into the numbers. Still reference. Here we have the historical sketches of Kentucky and the Filson Club History Quarterly. Historical collections of Ohio. I wonder if they just have every state here. Illinois. The Midwest records section. New York Historical Society. Here we have directories. I don't know exactly what that means. Tacoma City Directory. Is that like a Yellow Pages? Not that those exist anymore. Reference book. Probably can't take it home. I guess it's just a list of people and businesses. I don't even know. Some of these don't make any sense. BH, HLPR, NPRY, RRD1, Box 528A. What does that mean? What year was this? It doesn't seem to say. Oh, 1945. I like all the old ads. They're not terribly intrusive. Oh, let's see, that says Cotterell Myrtle D. was a social worker. So I guess these really are abbreviations. Maybe you get this directory book out and if you need to find a physiotherapist. Well, no, because you'd have to know who Ruth Gonsolin. What's the red? Red is okay, it looks like these might be lists of roads with what is that the numbers on the roads? I'm just guessing. Maybe I should go to the front of the section and it'll tell me. Street and Avenue Guide, a directory of householders. Wow. The Google Maps of 1945. And then there are Yellow Pages. Classified Buyer's Guide. Oh, it contains the advertisements and business cards of the more progressive businessmen and firms in the city. Are they progressive because they put their business in this book? They're using the highest levels of technology available. But these are just ads. Full page ads, even. Maybe they're progressive because they can spend a lot of money. And then this is the classified business directory. If you want to find Pat's used cars. Okay. Notice they don't have, they didn't seem to have phone numbers. Were those not common in 1945? I wonder what reason folks might have for needing to look up a city directory from 1945. Look at these huge ones, my word. Whoa. Cross-reference directory from 1980. Oh boy. Oh, the This one's even bigger. Oh my word. Relics of the past. I wonder, I'm sure someone is archiving current, like, online business directories, right? For historical reasons, perhaps? Alright, so, directory section. Let's move on to the next. Okay, so now we're in another biography section. Although I don't think these are, like, lists of people. Each book seems to be about a different person. So those are the type of biographies I'm a little more familiar with. I don't read a lot of biographies. I guess in the last couple years, I read one about Ada Lovelace. And I am actually currently reading one about Steve Jobs. Generally, I am sort of more interested in science books. Misha? Oh, Mishima. Who's that? Japanese writer for his plays and novels. All right. Actresses' flamboyant adventures in 18th century London's wild and wicked theatrical world. Whoa. Charlie Chaplin. I read recently that he was banned from the US because he was suspected of being a communist. Section now is North American history. Actually, I struggled with history most of my life. When I was young, I had a hard time understanding the reality of history and that it affected real people and helped contribute to the world that I know. And then as I got older, history was just too painful to read about, which I know is not a good excuse. That tends to be my problem, especially reading about the 20th century. Looks like we're in European history now. Spain. Russia. Here's a, okay, this So they're using a Dewey Decimal System, just not everywhere. But these are the history Dewey numbers. Here's the outline. If you don't remember it from elementary school or primary school, I certainly don't. We should check out the 100 section. 600 section. 500. 700. Let's see if we can make our way through all of those. Looks like we're still in history. This is Chinese history. Living in time. Sing as one who on a tilting deck sings, to keep men's courage up, though the wave hangs that shall cut off their sun. As stormcocks sing, flinging their natural answer in the wind's teeth, and care not if it is a waste of breath or birth carol of spring. So, I guess we found the literature. Ghost speaking. He is waving to me from the farthest room. At the end of innumerable corridors, the ghost I will become. Nothing in the history of the universe has so tenderly familiar a face. Wow. I love it. All day I have been writing you a letter. Now, after hours of gazing at the page and watching the screen of rain, I have enacted a flow of endless letters in my head, all of them different, and not one in any written shape to send. Those letters never end. In between pages of wishing, I walked to the river and wrote you of how the water wrinkles and eddies and wanders away. That was easier to say. I wrote of how the snow had fallen and turned blue, and how the bush you wanted could not be planted. Some pages were all remembering the places, faces, frontiers, rooms, and days we went through ages ago. Do you do this too? Always coming back to snow. Mostly an endless, useless run of questions. How are you now? How is it there? Who will you and I be in a year? Who are we now? Oh no, there is no letter to send you. Only this stream of disconnected brooding, this rhythm of wanting, cumbersome in words, lame. Come. Forgotten where I picked this up from. 9:14. Read. Oh, there's no way I'm gonna put it on this shelf. I want to punch in the throat. Alice in Tumblerland. What? And other fairy tales for a new generation. Peter Pan finally has to grow up and get a job, or at least start paying rent. Cinderella swaps her glass slippers for Crocs. The tortoise and hare Facebook stalk each other. Goldilocks goes gluten-free. And Rapunzel gets a buzz cut. The hare got a high-powered job in the tech industry straight out of college. He was known for never sitting down at work and always chugging energy drinks. He invented a new app every day at lunch, though many of them were about sandwiches. The tortoise traveled the country by train, just looking out the window and thinking. It didn't bother him that the hare was out there making the big bucks. He was doing his own thing, something quieter, more spiritual. The tortoise's travel memoir got published, and the New York Times gave it a glowing review. The tortoise posted on Facebook about how humbled he was by all the success. And he remembered his old rival, the hare, and thought, I knew I'd outshine that guy in the end. Well, this is cute. The ugly duckling still felt gross compared to everyone else, but then she got Instagram, and there's this one filter that makes her look awesome. This seems to be the comedy section. So, comedy. Literature. I think we're back in poetry or just literature. Maybe. Dudes reading. The creators of the original Instagram sensation. Well, it's what it says on the tin, I guess. Good. That exists. We have some music here. Conga, bongos, and rhythm technique. I think this is sheet music. I Oxford Book of Sea Songs. These are sea shanties. Songs America voted by. Encyclopedia of TV and Movie Classics. Is that songs? Music industry that I sent them. Oh, I love this song. Cool. Music you can listen to. CDs. See, back in the day, we had these ancient devices called CD players. I hope all of these have been digitized. They're gonna degrade over time. And grease paint. The evocation of yesterday and the day before. I guess it's just a book about the theater profession, maybe? I read a book recently called Rainbow's End, but it wasn't this one. Oh, the Judy Garland show. I don't know much about Judy Garland. She had a television series called The Judy Garland Show. Judy Garland Show. It was sabotaged from the very beginning. It became a single season casualty. That's a shame. Seem to be back in biographies again, but this time it's biographies of musicians. They get their own section, I guess. Some European stuff here. Song, dance, and poetry of the court of Scotland. Italian. So these are music across. Why you like it? The science and culture of musical. Next time you hear a rhythmic pop song, pop or rock song, think about where you would naturally clap your hands to the beat. Now try clapping at a different metric level. What does that do to your experience of the song? How many different levels can you easily clap to? It's the overtone, stupid. I can almost hear the musical counterpart to political strategist James Carville yelling at me. Any attempt to explain overtones involves mouth-based explications. I feel like I vaguely know what an overtone is. I don't know that I could describe. Overtone series. This seems like a good book for people who are into music. I mean, who isn't into music, but I mean, you know, academically or whatever. Wolf is the sound. You know what that is? What is this section? Textiles? No, maybe just art in general. This is paintings. Galore. A compendium of cultured cats. Oh my goodness. Oh, how cute. too precious. These are also sheet music. What year was this? Song may be sung in public without fee or license. That's nice. Oh, but the public performance of an entire parodied version is strictly prohibited. Hey, newsflash, you can't restrict parody. That's called free use, my friend. Visual property idea. You can use this intellectual property anywhere, but you can't make fun of it. Painting. Self-portrait. Pottery, Fabergé. Here we have landscape architecture, it says. Art and tradition. Contemporary American realism. Oh, I guess that is realism. Arts of the Young Republic. This is like art history, I suppose. Mysterious builders of Stonehenge and Karnak. The recurrent theme of this book is mankind's everlasting battle against death and oblivion. So dramatic. Thank you. I just doodle? What's up with that? Ancient Egyptian art and architecture. A very short introduction. Joy of keeping a root cellar. Do I need a permit to build a root cellar? Maybe someday when I have a real house. Right now I have a townhouse, which is just sort of a glorified condo. Safety manual. Boots. Construction. Birdman. Oh. The Wright brothers. The battle to control the sky. Your brain needs a hug. True that. It's a lighthearted way to talk about this topic. It's kind of fun. Science and the secret world of sleep. Club Disney was right. Talks about Bruno the dog and Cinderella. I was dreaming. I've seen night terrors. Political science. I don't know if it's just that it's getting later or I'm going down too far, but there's a lot of people around now and I can't quite figure out how to keep filming or keep talking. So I'll keep walking around, filming where I can. But I might not be saying a whole lot. Section has a whole bunch of old newspapers. was a literary supplement. I guess this is only from 2009, but it feels very old. I guess newsprint doesn't stay crisp for very long. Washington businesswoman. 1933. Research month. Is this a specific club? Businesswoman club. I wonder what the context of all of this is. Presented to your view as a lesson, a horrible lesson showing the fate of those who cannot mind their own business but must get into quarrels. Oh. Got in between a cat and a dog. Okay. Oh, my light globes now. We are out of the book section and into the magazine section. I know these look like books, but they're compilations of magazines. Oh, they're really packed in here too. I think they unbound the magazines and compiled them into these books. And they can put in several magazines into one book. These are, for all 1 year. These are all the 1930s. 1931. Not a classically successful time for medicine. Although the Red Cross existed, so that's nice. 20 cents. Got some ads, of course. There's a poem. Magazines are definitely their own brand of historical relevance. Like they're less curated, I guess, than books. And there's a high volume of topics and stuff serialized every month. This is the last stretch of the spiral. So I'm gonna walk around a little more and then say goodnight for now. Thanks for joining me on this exploration, and I'll see you again soon.